Good morning, Our Lady of Lourdes. And this is due now, Our Lady of Lourdes official 8:15 update. Today is Tuesday, January 8th, 2012. I'm Jack.
And I'm Chris.
Today, we're here to talk to you about the NFL playoffs, first with the AFC. Chris, you're a Ravens fan. How do you feel about their victory over the Colts?
I think that it was a tight game throughout the whole thing. And I think that the Colts had a good matchup with the Ravens. But I think the Ravens are a team, you know, they have to win.
How do you feel about Ray Lewis obviously announcing his retirement after the season?
Mm-hmm.
And this was his last game at home in Baltimore.
Mm-hmm.
And Channel 2 went live to when he was coming out of the tunnel. And you saw right before him, like tradition, Ed Reed came out before him and he was getting the crowd ready.
Mm-hmm.
And when Ray Lewis came out, how did you feel and how do you think the fans felt?
I think that the fans were very emotional in the game, because obviously his last home game is going to be missed by Baltimore everywhere. So I think that being him just made the game that much better.
Now, if you think about it, Baltimore's been kind of non-consistent mm-hmm. when he's gone. Do you think just that emotional level and like the intensity he brings to a football game helped the Ravens out?
Yeah, because intensity is everything, you know? You got to play.
All right. Also now for the NFC, the Seahawks are moving on, and they will be facing the Falcons.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how do you think that matchup is? Because the Falcons are obviously the number one seed, and mm-hmm. the Seahawks were the lowest seed. How do you feel about this matchup going into this game?
I think the Seahawks are going to be the underdogs in this game. I want the Seahawks to progress in their postseason, but, I mean, versing the Falcons is going to be a challenge.
Now, this might be a game that the Seahawks can use. Do the Falcons have great corners mm-hmm. and secondary players in their safeties?
Right.
And the Seahawks have Marshawn Lynch and Russell Wilson, two guys that can run. Now, is this a game that they're really going to rely on run more than pass?
I think that they're going to be consistent with both, you know, because Marshawn Lynch is always on point with his runs, and wide receivers need to play their game.
All right, also now, Green Bay and 49ers. We've been talking about this for a while now, and it's really hard to decide who has the edge. Green Bay Packers, when you think about it, they have all their wide receivers, their tight ends,
mm-hmm.
their running backs, all guys that are passing threats, and even guys like Randall Cobb, who are wide receivers, can run the ball.
Mm-hmm.
They're just such a diverse team, and now that they have Charles Woodson back, their defense is even better. But the 49ers, on the other hand, Colin Kaepernick, he can run, he can pass.
Mm-hmm.
He has Vernon Davis on his side. And just the 49ers' defense is impenetrable.
Right. I think that Aaron Rodgers is a very mobile quarterback, which means he stays in the pocket, doesn't really run out of it, unless if he's really in trouble. But since Kaepernick can run, I think that would be the deciding factor in this game.
All right.
And this sport talk is brought to you by Subway,
the official training restaurant of Chris, Jack, and athletes everywhere.
Hi, I'm Brooke. Today, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. in the APR, is the volleyball clinic for grades 6 through 8. And if you've never played volleyball before, but you're interested in playing, make sure you come to this, because it'll be a lot of fun, and you'll learn a lot of new things. Also, for the 8th graders, make sure you come to this so we can win the Teachers versus 8th grade volleyball game. On February 8th is the Father-Daughter Dance, and the money for that is due on February 1st. If you've never been to the Father-Daughter Dance before, I really suggest that you come because it's a really nice experience. Also, on Thursday is the bake sale, so if you bring in a doll, you can get a juice and a snack. Today's prayer is the Glory Be, so click here to pray along with us. As always, please remember to keep in your prayers Matt Carolyn, all the victims of Hurricane Sandy, and for the repose of the souls of all the students, teachers, and family members of Sandy Hook Elementary School. And that's all for your official 8:15 Our Lady of Lourdes update. Do now, Our Lady of Lourdes.